Thank you. Good evening and welcome to the 2020 Lieutenant General Harrison Preparatory Commencement Ceremony. Please join me in recognition of our national anthem performed by Harrison Prep Senior Madeline Hawes.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets in glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
graduates, families and friends, staff and faculty of Lieutenant General William H. Harrison Preparatory School. Welcome to the 12th Annual Commencement Ceremony. It is my pleasure to welcome all of you to this prestigious evening. Tonight, we join together to celebrate. To celebrate these 47 young men and women and launch them forward into the next phase of their lives. I am Kevin Ruprecht, the very proud principal of this great school, and of these students whom are garbed in mortarboard and gown, ready ever so impatiently for the part of the evening for the superintendent to declare that all 47 have completed their graduation requirements, and then for our school board member to receive them as the graduates and direct us to award the diploma. Before we get to that fun part, let me take a brief moment to thank some of our guests this evening. Our Superintendent Ron Banner and Assistant Superintendent Brian Labaugh for their leadership of our schools. We thank our school board members, Dr. Marty Schaefer, Carol Jacobs, Anthony Velez, Alyssa Anderson Pearson, and Paul Wagaman for guiding our school district. We thank the administrative leadership of Harrison Prep, Assistant Principal Tracy Lund, International Baccalaureate Coordinator Erica Cox, and school counselors Kim Deming and Chad Ramos. We also thank all of the teachers and staff who have educated these students for all of these years with all of the heart and instruction they can muster. I would like to give special acknowledgement to our namesake, General Harrison, for all of his contributions to our community. I would also like to thank the staff and administration of the Clover Park School District who work diligently every day in support of all student learning. For it takes all of us to get all of these students to this moment in time. Finally, parents and families, I share a warm-hearted thank you for sharing your students with us. Here at Harrison, we are a 7-year school, and for the Puma's share of these last 7 years, this class has been together. 28 have been with us all 7 years. Sure, we have lost some students over the years, family and military movements, but this class has also received new members that have made this class what it is today. Each graduating class defines itself. Each class develops its own personality. This class is best described as perseverant. This class was born just post 9/11. And now this class graduates in this era of COVID. Everything that life has put in front of them, this class as a whole group and each student as individuals has persevered. I am proud of this class. I am proud to tell you that each of these 47 have a plan for after tonight. We have a Puma's fair share heading off to college and universities. We have many students heading off to the University of Washington and Pacific Lutheran University, Washington State University, the University of Hawaii, Columbia Basin College, Brigham Young, University of Portland, George Fox, Northwest Nazarene, Columbia University, Purdue, Central Washington University, Pacific University, University of Pittsburgh, with many more going off to local colleges with plans to attend university after. If I'm using an incorrect adjective, perseverant, to describe this class, then one of my English teachers can give me a better word after tonight's ceremony. Seniors, I'm excited for you. I've been telling you that for quite a while now. I'm excited because you are about to embark on the next phase of your life. You have all made choices and hard decisions as to where your feet will be taking you next. I encourage you to keep following your feet in the direction of your goals, not allowing yourself or anyone else to hinder your determination. And do not allow any perceived barrier to impede your trajectory. Do what is right, leading by example, showing all whom you encounter just what perseverant means and looks like. Now we share with you again our excitement for you as you keep moving forward toward your desired goals and dreams. Continue to be principled, open-minded, risk-takers, who are inquirers, caring and reflective, eloquent communicators who are knowledgeable thinkers. Seniors, do me a favor this evening. Give your moms and dads, grandparents, all of your loved ones a giant hug this evening, because they are just as filled with emotions as you are. My young friends, let us continue this evening's ceremony and get you launched into the next chapter of your life, so you may begin grabbing a hold of the dreams that everyone hopes for you. Thank you. Our senior speaker selected for this evening is Jada Simpson. Her speech is titled 2020 Tunnel Vision. Please welcome Jada Simpson.
Good evening. My name is Jada Simpson. Now, first off, I would just like to thank God, because without him, I don't even know where I'd be. And second, I would like to thank my family for all of their support. And of course, thank you to the HP staff, because all of you guys have put up with us and encouraged us during this time. And to my senior class of 2020. Honestly, before I even start, I just want to say that all year we've been hearing a lot of talking and speeches and chattering at us, either from assemblies or elsewhere. So I will try to keep this as short as possible, but of course, make it worth your time. Without going super in-depth and saying all the things we did this senior year, I just want to start this off by asking you this one question. What is your reason for living? Now, before you go on and start thinking, oh my gosh, I've heard this so many times from my teachers and from my parents, let me just express this to you in a different light. So many people in the world have a hard time answering that question, when we would think it would be one of those simplest things to answer. You know, your purpose, your reason for being who you are. There's no right or wrong. You know why? Because every single one of us is different, unique, and brilliant in our own way, and with a path set out for us. Now you may say, well, Jada, okay, that is not convincing enough to show me who I am or what my purpose is. Well, I'm glad you asked. To me, I think that for every decision we make, whether we know our reason for living or not, it revolves around us striving to be happy. Think about it. There are simple things that we do every day because we know that in the end, it will bring us happiness or some sort of feeling that makes us happy. The clothes that you buy, the clothes that you wear, the makeup that you put on, or for the boys, the cologne or Axe that you spray. It could be from something as obvious as the food we eat or something unnoticed like a clean bedroom or a clean kitchen. We are all aware of what it's like to study, and you may be thinking, well, Jada, I hate studying. How does that bring me happiness? Even things we know that we are doing right now, we know will eventually end up making us happy in the future. I'm pretty sure we've all had this same thought in our head. Studying leads to good grades, and good grades leads to scholarships and attending a good college, and a good college leads to a good job, and a good job leads to a lot of money, which can help me buy a nice car, fancy clothes, slamming house, or whatever your idea is that can overall make your life better. But even though we have that plan set out in our heads since we were kids growing up, we didn't think of all the different things we had to go through in order to reach that goal. We have just taken about all the tests we had to take during the 12 years we've been in school, anywhere from the SBAC to the ACT. And of course, we can't forget all the fire, earthquake, and lockdown evacuation drills we had. And after it was done, everyone would say, "Todo está bien." Even right now, we're going through something that we never would have expected. Life throws curveballs at you, and they indeed can be very drastic, especially when it's something you're not even expecting. But you know what, class of 2020? We still have tunnel vision, and we should be happy. You know why? Because of who we are. Because we are the first. The first to have our IB exams canceled. The first to graduate virtually. And of course, we all cannot forget how we were the first class Dr. Maniagra ever taught at HP. We've grown together, and we have each and all learned from each other. It is like Dr. Maniagra said from the very start, we need each other. Whether you've noticed it or not, you did, despite our differences, and that has led us here, to be the first. But now it's time we move to our first independently. Whether it be your first moving out of home, being the first in your family to go to college, the workforce, the military, we can do this. You can do this. If we can endure drastic changes our lives have experienced these past few weeks, we can hustle through whatever life decides to throw at us. These changes help us to grow as individuals, and the growth we obtain will help us to be stronger as people. And in the end, it leads to our reason for living, happiness. So class of 2020, no matter what else life decides to throw at us with, we can adjust with change. Part of the journey is the end, right? And even though it may very well sound like it came from Iron Man and Avengers Endgame, it is very true. Let your reason for living be based upon how you define success, and let success not be defined by how many goals you set for yourself or how many of them you accomplish, but how you attempted those goals. Success can bring happiness, but only if you do it the right way, and not all forms of happiness come from the goals you accomplish. The whole point is, do what makes you happy, whatever that looks like. Don't compare someone else's success to what your goals are towards your happiness. You don't have to have the best fashion or keep up with the fashion trends. You don't have to be the funniest person in school or a drawing queen. You don't have to love R&B or love country. You don't even have to be a cross-country star or a car guy. You can be you by doing what makes you happy. In the end, we're all chasing a bag, right? Enjoy the journey. Soak up the moments. We've had a lot of practice with this together, so now it's time we go our own ways independently. As much as I've looked forward to this day, it has come so fast, and indeed this chapter is about to end. But today is one of those days we say goodbye. And senior class of 2020, how blessed I am to have known a class that's so hard to say goodbye to. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Jada Simpson. I would like to introduce Assistant Principal Tracy Lund to recognize our honor graduates.
Thank you, Mr. Ruprecht. I am Tracy Lund, Assistant Principal. It is my privilege to announce this evening our honor graduates. The following students have graduated with a cumulative grade point average of 3.5 or higher. Jessica Niemeyer, Madeline Hawes, Grace Livingston, Elizabeth Carmona Delgado, Jasmine Wilson, Dante Ost, Jessica Hernandez Hernandez, Deanna Marie Pangalinan, Valentino Gomez Bernal, Anthony Thompson, Alexandria Doro Gilbert, Violet Sung, Michelle Rogers, Jasmine Frank, Jesse Daniels, Michael Austin, and Jada Simpson. Congratulations to our honor graduates for their commitment to academic excellence.
Thank you, Mrs. Lund. I now ask Counselor Chad Ramos to the podium to recognize our seniors, awards, and scholarships.
My name is Mr. Chad Ramos, one of the school counselors of Harrison Prep. We want to recognize our seniors for their awards and scholarships. The list of scholarships and awards recipients are listed in your program. This class has been awarded a cumulative total of nearly $1 million in scholarships and awards. Families and friends, we know that these students could not have achieved these accomplishments without your love and dedication. Please give these students a big round of applause for all their hard work.
Thank you, Mr. Ramos. It is now that time, ladies and gentlemen. I direct your attention to Superintendent Ron Banner to present the Lieutenant General William H. Harrison Preparatory graduating class of 2020.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ron Banner, and I am proud to serve as the superintendent of the Clover Park School District. I have the distinct honor of presenting the Clover Park School District graduating class of 2020 to our board of directors. I want to start by saying thank you and welcome to our school board directors. Board President, Dr. Marty Schaefer. Board Vice President, Carol Jacobs. Board Director, Alyssa Anderson Pearson. Board Director, Anthony Velez. And Board Director, Paul Wagaman. I also want to say thank you to the members of our Lakewood and Joint Base Lewis community. And I especially want to say thank you to the parents, family, and friends of our 2020 graduating seniors. Well, class of 2020, you made it, and you truly can say you made it unlike any other graduating class in recent history. I am especially proud of you for making it to this day because you weathered and continue to navigate a global pandemic to get here. Your efforts and your determination stand above any other class before you. Let me be clear, however, the class of 2020 will not be defined by the moments that were lost due to this pandemic, but rather by the moments that were gained. The gains you have made are the lessons that you learned during this hard time. The gains are within the character that you displayed when things got tough. You displayed grit and perseverance. You displayed empathy and kindness. You displayed honor, respect, and so much more. These are the things that you, the class of 2020, have imparted on this community and are taking with you to the next phase of your lives. Your student voice now becomes your adult voice. And now, more than ever, your voice matters. Because of this historic experience, you have a unique perspective that no one else can claim. And with that perspective, you have a duty to help shape the culture of your community. Move forward in life. Gain life experiences. Advance your trainings and education. Make mistakes and learn from them. And whether your next steps are local or they take you abroad, please consider this community as your home. And know that your voice is empowered to shape your community wherever you land. It is my pleasure to present the Lieutenant General William H. Harrison Preparatory School Class of 2020 to the Board of Directors of the Clover Park School District. Each graduating class has a distinctive character of its own, has distinguished itself in various ways, and has made its unique contribution. Each class, however, is made up of individuals who have met certain basic requirements and standards. I present this class to you, Dr. Marty Schaefer, certifying that each member has completed the prescribed course of study and has met the requirements for graduation as defined by state law, State Board of Education rulings, and the Clover Park School District Board of Directors. I ask that you accept this class and direct the award of diplomas to its 47 members.
Thank you, Superintendent Banner. And now to accept this class, Dr. Marty Schaefer, President of the Clover Park School District Board of Directors.
Amazing class of 2020. Have you ever wondered how a person measures his or her worth? I would suggest that your value is more than money, achievements, appearance, or even relationships. Yes, each of these can be important. However, they are not the most significant impact on one's sense of worth. What you believe about you is the primary factor that defines your worth. The Clover Park School District Board of Directors believes in you. We have committed ourselves to building a district and community that has your best interest at heart. because we know that you are our future. It's been our mission to set you up for success in life and to shape it as we go forward. And just as we need to be careful how we measure worth, the same is true for success. Success is more than grades, student portfolios, and even this achievement of graduation that we're celebrating and honoring today. Again, these are all important, but they do not define your success. We believe one of the most important influences for success is being a lifelong learner. This means that you value learning and know how to make education work for you, as you see it as a lifestyle to be engaged in and not a start and end date. We also believe in collaboration. This means that we value people and the unique perspectives that they bring to life. Think about it. A virus from another continent disabled the entire world. There is no place for isolation. We need to be shaping the world together, or we will be scrambling to do damage control. We have done our best to bring all voices to this ever-growing stage. This community has invested over $120,000 in each of you in education alone. Why? Because we believe in each of you. We want you to come together and to reshape life. Go fast, go alone, go far, go together. All voices are significant. Anthony Velez, one of our newest board directors, is going to share with you about the final two influencers, character and leadership.
Congratulations, class of 2020. Your accomplishments and achievements are amazing. As you continue into the next steps of life, take a moment to celebrate and reflect on your success. Enjoy what you have completed. Thank your family, friends, mentors, and most importantly, yourself. Now, moving forward into new challenges, it is time to make choices that will influence your life forever. Not all choices will be correct, and some may feel like failure or a setback, but these choices will all impact you and help form who you are, which is the essence of character. By making the strides and commitment to never give up, you'll achieve all your dreams and goals. Take the time to understand your true passions that drive you. Take risk and continue your education by never giving up and to always pay it forward to one another. True leadership comes from within your heart. To elevate and to help each other grow will give you more experience. Together, we can make a difference to inspire and navigate through life. As challenging as it may feel at times, do remember to take a moment to show appreciation of how far you have made it. And everything great takes time. Incremental steps and mastering each level will give you the confidence to pass your knowledge to others as they progress into their future endeavors. Stay optimistic, proud, and always willing to care for others. I thank you for all that you have done to set a great presence by being the graduate class of 2020.
On behalf of Carol Jacobs, Paul Wegeman, Alyssa Pearson, Anthony Velez, and myself as the Board of Directors of the Clover Park School District, I hereby accept the 2020 class of the Lieutenant General William H. Harrison Preparatory School, acknowledging the certification that each member of the class has met the requirements as specified by state law, by the State Board of Education, and by the Clover Park Board of Directors. I congratulate each graduating senior and now say, let the presentation of the diplomas proceed.
Thank you, Superintendent Banner and School Board President Dr. Marty Schaefer, for your messages to this graduating class. It is now time for the reading of the diplomas. Everyone in attendance of this commencement ceremony has played a significant role in the life of one or more of these graduates. Today is a time for celebration, reflection, happy tears, and looking forward. We as a community celebrate all of the names about to be presented. We do this to honor the work that led each of our graduates to this place and time. I invite IB Coordinator Erica Cox and High School Counselor Kim Deming to prepare to read the names of this year's graduates.
Good evening, I'm Erica Cox, the International Baccalaureate Coordinator.
Good evening, my name is Kim Deming, High School Counselor.
Carla Samantha Aguilar. Michael Gabriel Austin. Adriana Susanna Beal. Haley Christina Bowman. Lanice Aline Michelle Kamak. Elizabeth Carmona Delgado. Hansel Chicas. Alexandria Doro Gilbert. Jesse Colin Daniels. Amazia Jean Drankstevit. Eric Robert Figueroa.
Andrew Brennan Foster. Jasmine Clarice Frank. Tyson French. Valeria Gaspar Govea. Valentino Gomez Bernal. Jada Christine Green. Madeline Ava Hawes. Jessica Hernandez Hernandez. Amina Laika Hudson. Alessia Marjana Hutchinson. Joshua Nguyen.
Grace Adele Livingston. Jennifer Ruby Lozano. Gavin Moore. Alexander Nelson. Sylvana Renee Nicholson. Jessica Lee Nemai. Anthony Zyriel Oliver Chandler. Dante Jeremiah Ost. Dominic Panaro. Diana Marie Pangalinan.
Thelma Lou Bonse. Michelle Jessica Rogers. Brianna Gwynn Rosenberg. Marin Elizabeth Scott. Jada Felice Simpson. Alexander Blake Smith. Kyle Alexander Smith. Violet Lexi Sung.
Jacob Starr. Mackenzie Claire Steele. Ariana Nikayla Thomas. Anthony Lynn Thompson. Elizabeth Torres. Jasmine Yvonne Wilson. Meredith Abigail Rosemary Young.
Families and friends of Harrison Prep, I present to you Senior Class President Grace Livingston to instruct her class in the turning of the tassel.
Congratulations, Class of 2020. My name's Grace Livingston, Senior Class President. Now, seniors, please join me in the turning of the tassels. Congratulations, Class of 2020. And remember, the best is yet to come.
Thank you, Ms. Livingston, and the Class of 2020. Thank you to all the families and friends in attendance this evening. And thank you to the exceptional staff of Lieutenant General William H. Harrison Preparatory. Graduates, go forward.